The study of Tikal revealed the refinement of Maya culture during this classic period. It was also a reality in rival cities like Calakmul or Copan. The first impressive feature is their architecture. The Maya produced a vast array of structures, and this tells a lot about this society, because the planning, the construction, the decoration, all of this required a central organization, a certain degree of prosperity, political means to mobilize such a workforce, and a specialization of craft. Only a complex society can do this. The pyramids were temples, and they concentrated in the center. Then the rest of the city grew around it, sometimes chaotically. The central structures were carefully placed, but further development could be messier as the city expanded along the centuries. The elite, the rulers, the aristocracy, the priests, they lived in the center, in palaces that were abundantly decorated with sculptures, frescoes, all of this painted on plaster or modeled in stucco. The art and the decorative features we know of are essentially royal or aristocratic. It is likely the rest of the population didn't have access to this. The Maya art tradition is considered the most diverse in terms of variety of subjects and techniques in all of the Americas, because there were regional styles and a multiplicity of objects and ornaments turned into works of art. The Maya had apparently a preference for the color green or blue-green. One of the most precious materials to them was apple green jade, and they created a wide range of objects from it, statues, jewelry, or masks. The aristocracy practiced dental modification, that is to say, they sharpened their teeth, and they sometimes wore encrusted jade in their teeth. Sculpture was abundant, and especially on facades, of course only for temples and palaces. Stucco was brightly painted, so that in contrast to the ruins of their cities that now look very grey because the paint has gone, the Maya city during the Classic period was extraordinarily colourful and ornamented. Frescoes were also very common inside the buildings. The walls were coated with plaster and painted with cream, black, and red. Another important resource was obsidian. It served utilitarian purposes for everyday life, for example for knives or arrows, but it could also be sculpted or crafted into decorative objects that had no function as a tool. This is lesser known because they have been mostly lost under the wet and hot climate, but textiles were also important to them. We know it from their depiction on murals. Textiles were high-value items made of cotton and dyed. The clothing of the nobility could also include jaguar pelt and other types of fur. And there are more examples. There were countless forms of ceramic art too, bone carving, metalware,